Hey, good morning. This is Diary of a Coach, episode 292. It's a beautiful Saturday morning, coming live to you from Abuja, the federal capital city of Nigeria in West Africa. How are you? I've had a good night. It's been a long week and it's not abating yet. I'm back home. Thank you to everyone telling me welcome back. Thank you, Idenye. See you. Thank you, Dr. Faith. Yes, I'm back to Abuja. I'm tired, but we got to go. As you can see, I'm in the office because in a few minutes, charge up. Our goal setting and emotions mastery session kicks off at 9 a.m. So if you're in Abuja, you can still join up. And if you're coming, you can still make it on time. Even though the first batch is full, I think the next batch starts by 1 p.m. So if you have not registered to be at Charge Up today, you can still join the 1 p.m. session. There are about 5 to 7 slots left for 1 p.m. The morning session is full. So don't bother coming this morning if you haven't registered. But if you intend to make it, you have chances to come at 1 p.m. to 4 p.m. So call the number and you can get your slots immediately. And of course, if you'd like to sponsor slots, we're very, very willing and grateful to take your payments to register and announce some scholarships. We'd like to see if we can sponsor 5 to 7 spaces so we can announce a scholarship. So roll. Today's episode is very straightforward. It says it's okay to dream big. It's okay to dream big. So I was in Calabar and I was talking with my host. And we're talking about the things we had planned some 3 years ago. In 2017, Isaac Onoja and I were talking about some dimensions of training and we're thinking about some collaborations and we're hoping for some kind of open doors. And you know, so when we're in Calabar, we're appraising those 3 years ago, the things we were dreaming about and how some of them are beginning to show up and manifest. I think that the most important thing, the most powerful thing that you have as your asset is your dream. Your dream requires no permission, requires no visas, requires no applications, requires no proposal writing, requires no one's vetting. You can dream all you want and it's allowed to dream. But guess what? As you dream and rehash your dream and dwell on it and ponder on it, then you begin to find that there are instrumentation that supports your dream. We call it the conspiration. The conspiration is a spiritual philosophy that says all that matters for your dream begins to come together. All that needs to happen for your dream to happen begins to come together. The kind of people you need to meet begin to walk into your life. The kind of places you need to be begin to show up. The kind of opportunities you need to have begin to show up. And that is what it is to dream. The most poor of us are those that dream the least. The poorest among us are those that dream the least. And so you need to step up the quality of your dreams. You need to step up the quality of your dreams. You need to be able to task yourself to dream what scares you. But you guess what? The first time you will dream big, you're going to be scared. It's going to be like an impossibility. When you permit yourself to have that dream again, or extend that dream, or think more about that dream, guess what? Your conscious mind begins to make a shift to accommodate the possibility of that dream. That is why if, for instance, today you go to the White House or you go to Aso Rock or you go to somewhere that you've never imagined before, let's assume by some stroke of luck, you were taken there the first time, that first time, you will feel intimidated. You will feel scared. You will feel like, oh my God. But guess what? As you repeat that visit second time, third time, fourth time, fifth time, it begins to become normal, such that someone else that is coming for the first time is going to be wowed, and you'll be like, okay, why is he being extra? That's how dreaming is. The first time you dream really big, you'll be in awe, you'll be wowed, you'll be scared. But the more you repeat that imagination, the more comfortable you become. And the more comfortable you become, the more possible it begins to look like. And the more possible it begins to look like, then the more realistic you begin to prepare for it. And the moment you start preparing for what you are dreaming, you have set in motion an energy that makes them begin to happen for you. So the first task is to dream. The first task is to dream. The first task is to permit yourself to dream foolishly. I like the way Steve Jobs puts it. He said, be foolish as much as you are hungry. He said, be foolish as much as you are hungry. So you should be hungry for everything possible and then be foolish in dreaming about it. Dream about anything. Dream about all the possibilities. And anyone that really looks attractive to you, dream it again and again and again and again. Repeat the dream as often as you can. Write it down. Paint a picture of it. Collect information that looks like it. Draw schematics around it. Do as much as you can to gather information and become more aware about what you're dreaming of. And the more you dream, the more you realize that it is not so hard after all. And the more you realize that it's not so hard after all, the more you begin to see that, but what would it take for me to even do this thing? And then begin to write out possibilities. And then begin to write out who you need, what you need, how it can be done. That is where dreaming takes you to. And then before you know it, you meet one person. Just one person can change your life forever. Just one trip can change your life forever. Just one incident can change your life forever. Just one breakthrough can change your life forever. But how do you know which person, which incident, which breakthrough, which experience will change your life when you've not dreamt it to be able to create the picture of what you need to have? So today's diary is all about dreaming. And don't forget, this is our week of studying. So I'd like you to go online and study. Ask yourself questions like, what is a vision board? What is a dream board? What is a dream map? Ask yourself these questions and immerse yourself in your dreams. Create 10 minutes in a day. Just shut your eyes and just imagine. Just dream. Just dream. Right now, in our office, we are in our dream state. This office is like a sample of where we are going. So to us, this is a dream come true and is a sample of a bigger dream that we're going. That's how dreams happen. You imagine, you produce. Then you imagine, then you produce. Then you imagine, then you produce. That is how to grow in this life. Oh. And I invite you into the land of dreaming. I invite you into the atmosphere of dreaming. I invite you into the realm of imagination and dreaming. So the week starting tomorrow is going to be called the week of imaginations. The week of imaginations, positive imaginations. Imagine everything possible. Imagine the breakthroughs. Imagine the wealth. Imagine the power. Imagine the success. Imagine everything imaginable. And all is available for you for the taking. So go on now and dream. This is Diary of a Coach, and this is episode 292. I am imagining that the BSG Summit is sold out. I am imagining that our premarital course is sold out. I am imagining that our Fear Mastery course is sold out. I am imagining that so much money will be paid this week, and then we're doing bigger things. I am imagining that so many lives are being touched by our services and our system. I am imagining that many people are finding healing from Diary of a Coach. I am imagining that just before the end of this video, someone is going to sponsor 5 people to attend the 1 p.m. class of Charge Up. Of course, my imaginations are happening and my dream is coming true. Join me. Welcome to Dream Moments. Let's roll. Have a beautiful Saturday and have a wonderful day. I love you guys. This is Diary of a Coach and this is episode 292. God bless you and bye for now.